Hey everyone, my name is Sean Weinberg. It's very nice to be here. I'm sorry I don't have models to demonstrate for you. Although I wish, Dan, if I'd known you'd do that kind of thing, I would have asked you sooner. So I'm here today to talk about RezScore. RezScore has thankfully grown quite a bit. So when I first demoed RezScore, I think we'd had about 10,000 users. Now we're just shy of 500,000, and I hope you guys will help us reach 500,000 before the end of the month. RezScore does a bunch of cool things. The main thing we do, the thing we're known for, is that we instantly and automatically grade your resume for free. So the job search sucks, right? Anyone here think job search does not suck? Okay, job search sucks. One of the key problems with the job search is an absence of data, right? And there are all sorts of places where you could have information, but you're not getting them. You're not getting callbacks from recruiters. You don't know why you're not getting callbacks. You're applying to jobs or you're not finding the jobs. So we thought there's this one little slice of it that we're gonna start with that we're gonna solve, which is nobody knows what makes a good resume. So before I demo this, I wanna clarify, since we get this question all the time, this works for LinkedIn profiles, it works for whatever kind of profile you have, but most of you have resumes. So this is a resume of Cindy Bananas, that is not her name. Cindy is Vice President of Media Sales. This is an excellent candidate. She's led a lot of growth. She's done some really nice things. This is based off a real person's resume that we just gently edited to make it anonymous. And I'm going to upload this to RezScore. And you're going to see that it takes no time at all to upload to RezScore and to get your free grade. So you choose the file, then you opt in, and you either choose resume help or job leads. And this is, will be important for later. But for now, since Cindy doesn't exist, we're not going to opt her in. And we will get our RezScore. As you can see, this is a dev site. This is not live right now, so maybe I'll take you to the live site if this doesn't load better. Can you see that? Yeah. Okay, so you get your instant grade. You get scores on your brevity, impact, and depth. Cindy apparently has an excellent resume. She has an A+. We're also giving you, and this is new since the first time we were here, these industry scores. So these are important because both we want you to know how well you're marketing yourself to the industry you want, and if you're not crossing a certain line with these industry scores, it means that you're using the wrong kind of language on your resume. So she's in sales, so marketing, PR, sales, biz dev, that makes sense. Business management, all of that makes sense. But if it said tech, if she got a high industry score for tech and she's a vice president of sales, there would be a problem. One of the other things we built, which is not necessarily pretty but is incredibly useful, is the skills outlook. Every word on this skills outlook is a good word to have on your resume. So this is about SEOing your resume. Everybody wants to know what keywords to have on your resume. These are the keywords, and they're graphed against specificity to generality and against high demand to low demand. So every keyword here is useful, but they're graphed based on which are more useful and which are less useful. So once you've done that, we're going to provide you with three instant job matches. So we've parsed out your resume. Obviously, we've gathered a large amount of information. We've interpreted it, and we've matched her to jobs, and we've invited her to join the leaderboard. So this is another opportunity for you to essentially SEO your resume. This leaderboard is public. You get to choose which outlets you're on. So if you're an FBML developer, which I don't think exists anymore, but if you are, you can join the FBML developer leaderboard. So this is all great for Cindy. Cindy is a terrific candidate. She goes through this process, she joins the leaderboard, but she's a passive job seeker. And the majority of RezScore users are passive job seekers. This is a curiosity, or even if they're active ones, they're not necessarily applying to lots of jobs. So let's say, and here's a quick peek, I forgot about this, at the leaderboard. So the leaderboard is not currently searchable, and that's on purpose, and I'll get to that. But it's just kind of a scroll through. If you do better than a B+, then you get your spot on the general leaderboard or on the specific industry leaderboard. So this is really what I'm here to launch. This is RezScore Match. Now, if you're an employer, you have kind of an interesting problem, which is that very often you don't necessarily want the candidates who apply to your jobs. Right? Any recruiters here? Somebody, right? You have recruiting experience, somebody else? Right? So very often, A, people are not terribly good at writing job descriptions. And if you post a job description on Craigslist, you will get everybody and their mother applying to their job without any kind of self-filtering. And the candidates you want aren't applying to your jobs. So we built RezScore Match. And what RezScore Match does is instantly sends you users who've opted into job leads who match your job description or, better yet, your resume. So I'm going to create an account. And for now, all we're asking you for is that you opt in and you give us your email. There we go. Okay. So you get your candidate matching. Now, the holy grail of anything online having to do with the job search is to match candidates with job descriptions. But the problem is human beings are inefficient, specifically when it comes to job descriptions. So usually the person hiring hasn't actually written the job description, and if they have, they haven't necessarily put much thought into it. Or is Monitate here? Is anyone from Monitate here by any chance? All right, well, they've come in the past. So Monitate is a cool, have you guys all heard of Monitate?
Yes.
Nobody hears that? All right. Yes. Monitate is a really hot Philly tech company, and they've come to a couple of these PTMs. They're hiring engineers. Engineers will want to work at Monitate. So I was going to use one of their sample job descriptions. The problem was they didn't have a single meaningful keyword on it. So if you're an engineer, if you run a search for a job posting, you might use MySQL, right? You might use Java. You might use LAMP. They had none of those keywords, so they're just not going to get found, even though plenty of engineers would love to work for them. A better way of finding candidates is matching it to resumes. So companies have their rock star employees. If you copy and paste your rock star employee's resume here, we're going to match that for you. So I'm going to copy and paste Cindy's resume because she got an A, so we know she's great. She's a VP of sales. I need a VP of sales. Choose what level of matching you want, and I'm going to give you guys a code at the end of this so that you can get a free try. Tell us the desired job title, where you want the leads emailed, and click submit. And we will play the waiting game yet again. So while we're doing this, it's important to clarify that we're not just looking for keywords. So the way we built RezScore is we got a ton of hiring managers and recruiters into a room. We had them look at resumes and actually grade them on over a dozen different metrics, and that's an ongoing process. So this mimics what a human being would think of your resume, and the original RezScore mimics what a human being would think of your resume, and that's what's really essential about it. It's not the guesswork about what makes your resume better. It's based on actual algorithmic data. And sometimes just doing that works. Okay, so that works. So you're going to log in, you're going to see that. And view your matches. Now, sometimes it says you don't have matches. Again, this is the first public outing with this, so very much in beginning stage. And we've already got 29 matches. Now, when you do this, what's going to happen is you'll get your first group of matches, and then for the next month, as people upload who've opted in, you're instantly going to get sent those candidate resumes. So anybody here who's been a recruiter knows that time is really essential, especially when it comes to something like engineering and sales candidates. So they upload, they get a call from you minutes later, you're going to get them while they're hot. Now let's see if this matches. So all the way on the right, over here, are your matching scores. So there's the grade that we've given the resume, that's the letter grade, and these are your matching scores. So I'm going to look at the 7.5 at this resume. So this is the non-PDF version, maybe the PDF loaded. That should look nicer. There we go. So I don't know if you recall Cindy's resume, but she's got a lot of very deep experience with brands, with web brands. So this woman, Barbara, also has web brand experience. She launched chickswhoknow.com. So this is a very, very solid match. And again, we did this automatically. You didn't have to choose keywords because traditionally people are very bad at choosing the correct keywords. We parsed out, we interpreted the document that you uploaded, and we found matching documents. And for the next month, if you're recruiting for a VP of sales, you're going to keep getting resumes like this one. Have we beta tested? Yeah, just a couple of recruiters with mixed results so far. So I'm really hoping, and Rowan's going to ask me later, what do we want from the Philly Tech community? We want your feedback really badly. That's really it. We're going to be adding kind of check boxes, you know, this is a match, isn't a match, why isn't a match. The more feedback you give us, the better we're going to get it. Yeah, so engineering resumes, for example. I keep bringing up engineering resumes because they're very keyword rich. Traditionally. So the more specificity, in general, if you're a job seeker, specificity is absolutely essential. So what we found was specificity and numbers. If there's any way you can add a number into your resume, it really enhances your ability to get a callback. It also enhances our ability to interpret the quality of your work and match it. Sorry, as a recruiter, can you change the criteria for how we're matching? So right now, you would just create a new search, which is the easiest thing. And then, you know, as time goes on, hopefully we'll be able to develop those features. Not yet. We're in the process of doing that. We also have a lot of partnerships with big sites. We have partnerships with Simply Hired and Experience.com. And those sites feed us resumes. Those are obviously blinded, so we can't give right now. Hopefully we're negotiating those deals. Hopefully that works. But right now, we can't give you employers access to those resumes, but if things go well, we should be able to pretty soon. And that will obviously, that's our biggest limitation right now is the size of our database. So hopefully we'll be able to expand that a lot very soon. We have a bunch of API users and like two of them that pay. So I think we've above 70 at this point. So we're not, we have it because people kept asking for it, but it's just not where we see revenue in the future. So we threw it up there, and then if somebody's hitting a lot of calls and slowing down the server or something like that, then we'll call them and say, we'd like a couple of bucks. Sure. So the question is, he's skeptical about our ability to grade resumes. How do we do it? This is actually my favorite question because I hope that I will sound a lot smarter than I may have sounded so far. And people ask us this question all the time. The simple answer is that it's a bunch of Bayesian or Bayesian, depending on who you're talking to, filters. So Bayesian filters are basically a shortcut to pattern recognition. So when you upload your resume, you're getting compared against a filter of the A. First, we're assigning the industry scores, and then within the industry, you're getting compared to the filters results of the A resumes for that industry, the B resumes, so on and so forth. I think really the best qualifying factor are that A, we don't have that much data on who gets jobs because they have to tell us, but our click-through data on people who apply to jobs is way higher than anybody else who does any sort of job search technology. So usually you see about 2% click-through. We get about 6% click-through on those, which is much, much better. So we must be doing something right. The leaderboard, we get lots of emails from people that say that the leaderboard does match some jobs. We get plenty of A's. If you search for a RezScore on Twitter, you'll see we get lots and lots of A's. I hope that someone answers your question. The best answer is go upload your resume. Sure. So a lot of our users keep uploading what you actually didn't see. But you'd see on the traditional site, and I try and load it, but with the load issues we're having, I'm not sure it's going to be worth it, is we give you instant automatic tips for improvement, which are really our most popular features. So if you get a bad grade, we will tell you why. They're a little bit generic because you have to cover hundreds and thousands of different kinds of resumes, but that's your first step. And then we also have paid options for improvement, which we will eventually be sunsetting. How do they take it off of RezScore? What, you mean after they posted it to Leaderboard? So right now the mechanism is bad, which is they have to email us, and that's also in our dev pipeline to make it more automatic. You can just log in. If you unsubscribe to the leaderboard emails, which are updates on who's seen your leaderboard postings, that also works most of the time. Right, so the question, that's a great question. The question is, basically, we might be helping candidates who are terrible cheat. And the answer is yes, but it's, but I think it's good for the businesses too. It's good for the businesses, A, because the businesses are still inefficient in their hiring practices. And by doing things that get in front of them, you're going to ultimately help them become more efficient. So they have to start going through candidates. They have to start seeing what these improvements are. I also believe, and this is where I think people disagree with me, but I passionately believe that a person's ability to write a great resume does correlate to their ability to be a great employee. Right, because it takes specificity, it takes clarity, it takes an ability to sell yourself using clear, concise language. Those are all things you want in any kind of employee. So if you're able to improve your resume to that A+, I think it says something good about you. Sure. The question is, how do we reach out to colleges and how do we account for the fact that recent college graduates don't have that much information on their resume? So the core of our users are actually recent grad. We call them the bookends of the job search, so recent grads, and then people, let's say in their late 50s, who got fired in 2008, who are having a really hard time. Those are the people who most often interact with the site and keep coming back. It's not that hard to assess the quality of the content of a college graduate resume, and I've seen a ton of resumes, and I'm telling you that it's very possible to write a great resume with just a little bit of content. We have reached out to a lot of the career centers. We're going to keep doing that. Like our partnership with Experience is very helpful for that because they specialize in job boards for college grads. It's really hard to break into career centers because they have all sorts of legal issues if they receive any public funding. So that's just been the biggest barrier so far. Anyone else? Yes?
Have you scored the Yahoo CEO resume?
That's a terrific idea. The question is, have you scored the Yahoo CEO resume? And I'm sure he wrote a great one. But I'd love to do that. That's a great idea. Sort of. That's really where we're spending a lot of our effort right now is to get. So the beauty of a resume, and I meant to say this to you back there before, is that it's a structured, unstructured data set. You can predict with reasonable reliability what kinds of information is going to be on it. But there's going to be a huge amount of variety within that structured set, which makes it a lot of fun if you're a data geek. So we're getting there. part of it has to do with the industry score. So we, the information we give away is much more generic than the information we collect, because we need to reach a big audience. So this isn't a great, very specific answer. We're getting there. It's very important to us. Not so much yet.
So a lot of recruiters, a lot of HR professionals are, you know, using LinkedIn to source candidates, and almost requiring their candidates to have a LinkedIn profile. Have you thought about layering this, you know, kind of the IP behind this on, you know, as a LinkedIn widget or on top of LinkedIn, and scoring that information?
Sure. So that is in the pipeline. Whenever we push this new design that you saw before, it's also going to have LinkedIn integration with it. So yes. And before I forget, anybody who wants to try the matching for free, go to rezscore.com/match/src/PTM. So that gives you one free try. Now, I assume you're all smart people, so you can figure out you could just create multiple logins to get that information. And that's true. Sabra, can you raise your hand for a second? That's my wife, Sabra. She's pregnant. She's due in 5 weeks. Diapers are very expensive. So please keep it to one for use.
The last question, that was great. So you already kind of answered this, but how can the affiliate community help you out?
Pregnant wife. really, the most important thing for us, and I'll just be frank here, one is we're not the best designers in the world, so if there's anybody who does design work who's looking for some part-time or consulting gigs, that would be great. And the other is just please do try this, and please really do give me feedback. My email is sean@rezscore.com, sean@rezscore.com. I'll be around, I'll give you a card, whatever. I would really love feedback. We do incorporate it pretty heavily.